We present I'm Sorry I Haven't a Clue, the antidote to panel games. At the piano is Colin Sell, and your chairman is Jack D.
Hello and welcome to I'm Sorry I Haven't a Clue. You join us this week on a trip to beautiful Stockport. Known throughout the world as neither Stockton nor Southport. At the time of the Norman invasion, Stockport was barely habitable and as a result didn't even warrant a mention in the Doomsday Book. Its name derives from the Anglo-Saxon word stock, meaning a stockaded settlement, and port, what you needed to drink by the gallon to endure living here. Likewise, nearby Cheadle-Hume takes its name from the Old English Cheadler, a military post or station, and Hume, meaning high up or above, so quite literally, above its station. Carved into the natural sandstone running beneath the town centre, Stockport's air raid shelters offer visitors an unparalleled insight into life in wartime Britain in the 1940s. Tourists wanting to sample life in 1950s Britain are advised to visit nearby Staley Bridge. Stockport is home to the Hat Works, the UK's only museum dedicated to hat manufacturing. Opened in 2000, entrance to the Hat Museum is free, although it does cost £7.50 to get out. Hatting was a dangerous profession due to the large quantities of mercury used in the felting process, which caused mental instability and hallucinations in many of the workers. And it's from this that we get the expression mad as a hatter. Of course, these days, a mad hatter is simply a local who's put money on Stockport County getting into the third tier of English football. But Stockport County Football Club aren't the only fourth tier talent in this town. Let's meet the teams. On my left, please welcome Andy Hamilton and Milton Jones. And on my right, John Coleshaw and Jan Ravens. And taking her place at the desk next to me to enjoy an evening of scoring, please welcome the ever delightful Samantha. Well, we start this week with a round inspired by national anthems. These days, younger citizens of many countries are starting to express concern at the outdated sentiments expressed in their national anthems and are looking for more contemporary songs to better express the national mood. A favourite in the Netherlands is Ain't No Mountain High Enough. And Scotland are considering Ain't No Sunshine. So in this round, teams, I'd like you to suggest some alternative tunes that you think might serve as national anthems to various countries around the world. Andy, you can start.
Myanmar's Shadow. Oh, OK, groaning from the start.
Jan.
Swing it, shake it, move it, make it, Peru do you think you are?
John.
When I was 21... it was a very good Zaire.
Milton.
Wake me up before you Democratic Republic of Congo go.
Guinea, 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 a man after midnight.
You make me feel like a natural Yemen.
Will you still need me? Will you still feed me when I'm Singapore?
I see a little silhouette of a man. Belarus, Belarus.
It was an itsy bitsy Palestini. Finish it yourselves.
I've got the Lulu 60s classic. Wheels. You make me want to shout.
Oh, Sudan, oh, Sudan.
Sudan next to me.
Don't cry for me, Chad.
Ice land, baby.
All the Senegal ladies.
Siam, what I am.
Uruguay works down the chip shop. Swears he's El Salvadorian.
Ebony and Ivory Coast.
You're Taiwan that I want.
I did it Norway.
Chim chimini, chim chimini, chim chim Peru.
Okay, well, it's now the time when I ask our teams to play the round called One Song to the Tune of Another. To understand precisely how this works, it may help to think of a song in terms of a criminal trial. The court represents the tune, while the people involved in any given trial represent the lyrics. Just as one trial substitutes another in the same court, so one set of lyrics can be substituted for different lyrics in the same song. Of course, when a trial collapses, the accused is often delighted to have their hearing brought to an immediate end, something we can all relate to, as I introduce at the piano Colin Sell. Excitingly, in our 50th anniversary year, Colin consulted his diary for July 1972 and discovered the entire month taken up with the words Donna Summer. He has such happy memories of that kebab shop. Okay, so we'll start with you, John Culshaw, and I'd like you to sing the words of Heaven Knows I'm Miserable Now by the Smiths to the tune of Who Do You Think You Are Kidding, Mr. Hitler?
Happy in the haze of a drunkard hour, but heaven knows I'm miserable now. I was looking for a job and then I found a job, and heaven knows I am miserable now. In my life, why do I give valuable time to people who don't care if I live or die? Two lovers entwined pass me by, and heaven knows I am miserable now. Oh, in my life, why do I give valuable time to people I'd much rather kick in the eye?
You know, Andy Hamilton, I'd like you to sing the words of Who's Afraid of the Big Bad Wolf to the tune of Cavatina, the theme to The Deer Hunter.
Who's afraid of the big bad wolf? Big bad wolf, big bad wolf. Who's afraid of the big bad wolf? Fa la la la. Long ago there were three little pigs, little handsome piggy weeks, for the big, bad, very bad, very big wolf, they didn't give three figs. Number one was very gay, and he built his house with hay, with a hay, hay toot. He blew on his flute and he danced with lady pigs.
Your turn now, Milton Jones. I'd like you to sing the words of I Predict a Riot by the Kaiser Chiefs to the tune of I Wanna Be Like You from the Jungle Book.
Watching the people get leery, it's not very pretty, I tell thee. Walking through the town is quite scary, and it's not very sensible either. A friend of a friend, he got beaten. He looked the wrong way at a policeman. Would never have happened to Smeaton, an old Leodensian. I predict a riot.
Ooby-doo.
I predict a riot.
Ooby-dooby.
I predict a riot. Predict a riot.
Weeby-dee-dee.
To get my taxi, The man in the tracksuit attacks me. He said that he saw it before me.
Thank you, Milton. It seems to have gone well. I actually couldn't hear that as I had wax in my ears. I put it in before the show. Now, Jan Ravens, finally it's your turn. I'd like you to sing the words of Milkshake by Kelis to the tune of the theme from The Archers.
My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard and they're like, it's better than yours, damn right, it is better than yours. I can teach you, but I have to charge. My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard and they are like, it is better than yours. Damn right, it is better than yours. I can teach you, but I have to charge. I know you want it. The thing that makes me what the guys go crazy for. They lose their minds. The way I wind, I think it's time. La 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 la, warm it up. La 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 la. My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard and they're like, it's better than yours, damn right, it is better than yours. I can teach you, but I have to charge. My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard and they are like, it is better than yours.
Jan, very good.
Thank you.
And well done not being distracted by the sound of the audience hammering on the emergency doors. Well, the next round, word for word, is all about words. The collective noun for a group of owls is a parliament, presumably because when they're shown a photo of the current cabinet, they go, hoo, hoo, and to wits. In this round, each team takes it in turns to exchange a series of words while the opposing team should challenge if they detect a connection between any of these words. Okay, so I'd like you to start exchanging completely unconnected words, John and Jan. Andy and Milton, your job is to try to spot a connection. If I uphold the challenge, I'll ask you to take over, and so on. So off you go, please, John and Jan.
Luminary.
Nostril.
Paint.
Lorgnette.
Clump.
Well, Andy has
What's lorgnette? Sorry, I didn't know what lorgnette was.
A lorgnette is one of those things where you sort of have your glasses on a stick and you look through them like that.
Ah, okay.
I thought it was a small patch of grass.
That's another round.
Okay, lorgnette, yeah. Right.
So did you get a connection between lorgnette
no,
and...
No, that was just... I just said what everyone in the room was thinking.
Look, it's not bloody QI, you know. John and Jan, back to you.
Where were we? Were we at lorgnette? Shall I say lorgnette again? Okay. Lorgnette.
Steam.
Oh, well, Milton's come straight in with...
What's steam?
No.
Yes.
I can see a connection because you would use a lorgnette, presumably with your glasses steamed up. Also, were there not steam lorgnettes in the early days of the Industrial Revolution? I think there were.
That's well known.
Yeah, everyone knows that, Jan.
All right, well, over to you. Over to you, Andy and Milton.
All right. Arctic.
Piffle.
Aubergine.
Blancmange.
Jan, you came in with a challenge.
Well, I'm sure that we've all enjoyed an aubergine blancmange. I mean, Heston Blumenthal made them famous, didn't he? You
know? But the word was piffle.
No,
aubergine,
it wasn't.
Blancmange. Piffle went, was earlier.
Yeah, I went aubergine blancmange. Yeah. Incredibly.
That was earlier.
No, you came from your team. You should know what you said.
Are you taking up the Barry Cryer role?
Yeah. I mean, his seat, it's the ghost. Yeah. Okay.
I think aubergine blancmange is also a colour on the Dulux colour chart as well.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I think there is a connection there between the two, in fact. Yeah, so, yes, it's over to Jan and John again.
Syrup.
Sprinkle.
Andy, you...
That was a big thing. The audience will back me up here. Syrup sprinkles in the 50s. That was a very popular sweet that dentists used to give you on the way out. And,
well,
Jan's probably too young to remember that.
We'll put it to the audience. Do you remember syrup sprinkles?
Yes!
Lying bastards. Never mind, OK, I'll give it to you. I will give it to you, because I'm a generous host. Back to you, Andy and Milton.
Tryst.
Asthma.
Cauliflower.
soil.
Oh, John came in with a cauliflower soil connection straight away.
Well, I suppose they grow in them, don't they?
Of course they do. What are you thinking of?
Not that kind of soil. In the 50s, dentists used to give out soil.
Nevertheless, I think there is definitely a connection. You didn't specify what kind of soil, and so I'm giving that to Jan and John. Back to you, Jan and John, for your connections.
Bays.
Basketry.
Rhubarb.
Rhombus.
Andy's come in with rhubarb rhombus.
Rhombus was a character in the children's cartoon Rhubarb. Only appeared in one episode.
And what did he sound like?
No, he rang at a doorbell and he was a sort of singing parallelogram.
Yeah. Sort of. Yeah.
Okay, fair enough. I think you've won that one. Rhombus from Rhubarb, that's fair enough.
What a shame.
The gong tells us that's the end of the round. We've run out of time for that one. No, I'm sorry, we really can't carry on. Take your coat back off. Okay, well, this next game is inspired by children's rhymes. Many rhymes have been around since the Middle Ages, but they're always evolving. Consider these updated classics. Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. Where there's blame, there's a claim. Or the grand old Duke of York has been cancelled. Okay, teams, the round's called Complete Bellocks, and in it, I'll present you with the opening couplet to a cautionary rhyme for our time, which you'll have to complete. So, Andy, first cautionary rhyme is for you to complete. Here's the opening couplet. Young John, who loved a cheeky dare, was visiting the town's steam fair.
A steamroller he didn't see, and now poor John is in 2D.
How about this one, Jan? Can you finish this? On lengthy journeys, tiresome Claire would oft repeat, are we nearly there?
Till father threw her from the car and crossly shouted, now you are!
And one for you to finish, Milton. Kicking cats, said young Kurt Zuma, shows I have a sense of humour.
But kicking dogs will be more rare, he whispered from intensive care.
And this is for you, John. All over town, a boy called Nick would wave a 5-foot selfie stick.
Later that day, I can well believe it, took a very good surgeon 4 hours to retrieve it.
Another one for you, Andy. Despite the warnings, naughty Maya climbed inside the tumble dryer.
Fred's in the washer, set to rinse. They've been going round together ever since.
One for you, Jan. When Civil War fanatic Scott turned up to watch the sealed knot...
He got a text. 'Twas from his wife, saying, Scott, I've left you. Get a life.
How about this one, Milton? While in the former Soviet bloc, young Vlad unearthed some Novichok.
Put it in the freezer against all advice, and he found he had a Novichok ice.
There's some leftover ones. Here are some for any of you to have a go at. While playing on a bouncy castle, young Mike, the irritating arsehole.
Invited friend Caroline, knowing that she's a porcupine.
Here's another one. One rather boring ferry ride, young Keith leaned too far off the side.
No one was there to watch him go, as they're so short-staffed on P&O.
How about this one? A disobedient boy called Milo sailed out to sea upon a Lilo.
Then on a yacht came Caroline. Yep, she's back, the porcupine.
All right. How about this one? Sid got his parents truly vexed by sending vulgar things in texts.
And then, and this was truly heinous, a full-size JPEG of his anus. His mother, she was sore aggrieved. His father, oddly, seemed intrigued. Peered at it, then said, "Bless my soul, is this our trip to Wookiee Hole?"
And finally, despite the council asking not, Mike kicked his ball an awful lot.
It must have been a strange disease that made the left one hang below his knees.
Well, this next game is called Censored Song, and it involves the team censoring various well-known but surprisingly inappropriate songs with the aid of a buzzer. Piano accompaniment will be provided by Colin Sell. Incidentally, Colin's latest musical composition has earned him the description, the new Lou Reed. And quite right, it is best left in the lavatory. Andy and Milton, you're to start, and I'd like you to censor a short medley of offending song lyrics. So off you go.
When you're in the whole world with you. When you're in the comes shining through. But when you're in, you bring on the sub your thing. Be happy again. Keep on in. Cause when you're in the whole world with you.
Brown in the ring. Tra la 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 la. There's a brown in the ring. Tra la 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 la. Brown in the ring. Tra la 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 la. Looks like a in a. Show me your motion. Tra la la la. Come on, show me your motion. Tra la 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 la. Show me your motion. Tra la 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 la. Looks like a in a.
We're no strangers to you know the and so do I. A full is what I'm thinking of. You wouldn't get this from any other guy. I just wanna tell you how I'm ink. Gotta make you understand. Never gonna give you, never gonna let you, never gonna around and never gonna make you, never gonna, never gonna tell a lie and you.
So I came to see him, and for a while, and there he was, this young boy, a stranger to my, strumming my, with his fingers, in my, with his, in me softly with his, in me softly with his. With his, me softly, with his.
Well, it's very nearly the end of the show.
Yes,
there there is just time to squeeze in a round called Plumber Fest. It's all about plumbers. Incidentally, Samantha's just finished a plumbing course and was excited to receive a call from an elderly gentleman whose washing machine had been leaking for a week. He asked her to pop round and assess the extent of the flood in his utility room. She says when she noticed it was as high as 6 inches, she carefully pulled out his old hot point, then went to the van for a pump. Anyway, teams, in this round, I'd like you please to suggest titles of bands likely to be playing at a pop festival for plumbers, together with some of the songs they might play. So, Andy, you can start.
Lulu.
John?
Dunny Osmond.
Jan?
Grout, grout, let it all out.
Milton?
Last night, a B-Day sprayed my wife.
Dino Rod Stewart.
Come back and finish what you started.
Pull up to the plunger, baby.
Yesterday, you said that you'd be here yesterday.
I should be so leaky.
Wonderful sound of the Bee Gees there, and how deep is your laugh?
Depeche Commode.
It was the plumber of 69.
The Who installed this, dear old dear.
Oh, Danny boy, the pipes are clogging.
Ian Dury and the blockage.
Flush.
And so, ladies and gentlemen, as the overcrowded elevator of time gets stuck on the forsaken fourth floor of fate, while the loose-boweled baby of belligerence slowly fills the putrid pull-up pants of posterity, I notice it's the end of the show. So, from the teams, Samantha and myself, and our audience here in Stockport, it's goodbye. Goodbye!
Andy Hamilton, John Colshaw, Milton Jones and Jan Ravens have been given silly things to do by Jack D, with Colin Sell setting some of them to music. The programme consultants were Fraser Steele and Stephen Dick, and the producer was John Naismith.